Hey everyone, Joe and I are going to be bringing you another map game commentary between Flux and Pleb this time. This was a playoffs match. Alright, let's get into it.
Yeah, this is one of the few, I heard, interesting first round playoff matches. We usually don't get very many of those, so it should be exciting.
So, Pleb with two frontline Ranger Ellie Mez, so pretty balanced build. Probably Lightning Surge on the Ellie, and Flux with two frontline Ranger Ellie Necro. So I think that the build advantage does go to Flux quite significantly because... Well, actually, I'm not sure, because they might have Spirit Bond on their split Ellie, whereas Pleb might have Mist of Regeneration. So yeah, actually, it does go to Flux quite a bit, I would think.
Usually on bigger maps, like Solitude for example, R&E is a slightly stronger build than Ranger Ellie Mesmer, just because they have better flag running options. I mean, that's mainly the reason. R&E is known as a really strong, actually counter split build on these big maps. It's really good at dealing with split builds and also being able to aviate.
So Flux is double running their first flag on Necro, and they're splitting their Ellie, but it's actually getting countered by the Ranger of Pleb, which is really, really great move by Pleb. If they were trying to send their Ellie to split side rather than the Ranger, then they would lose the split side quite quickly because, you know. Oh, actually, Pleb's Ellie gets bossed there without actually scoring the kill.
Well, it was like a delayed kill. Like, I don't know if it's just Observer messing up, but the Healmonk actually died off that, but it seemed really delayed.
Yeah. So yeah, as I was saying, the Ranger can actually defend the Spirit Bond Ellie. If the Ellie had Patient Spirit or Mystic Regeneration, then he would win a 1v1. But so that's a great move by Pleb to be running this Ranger and defending the Ellie with it. And we see the Ellie's now come to main team because of it.
It actually looks like Pleb's Ranger is a BA Ranger, which even gives it more killing power against this Ellie.
Yeah, BA with pin down, I believe I saw, which is fantastic for dealing with the Spirit Bond Ellie.
Yeah, so Flux has the boss on the Ellie, which theoretically is pretty strong, especially against what Flux has. Since Flux is splitting their Ellie, it's going to be really hard for them to punish this boss. They don't have very much range damage.
So Pleb is running on the Monk Flagger at the moment, which is pretty good. We see Flux is now sending their Ranger to split side as well, which will allow their Ellie to do more in split side, won't just get 1v1. The Ranger did engage in this 1v2. He actually might die if the flagger for a Pleb doesn't come and help him out.
Yeah, it looks like he's gonna eat this L Surge, maybe. Yeah, it looks like he's about to die here. He's degening out, and there's a kill right there. It's a great play from Flux.
Yeah, and a bit of unfortunate miscommunication from Pleb. So that will give Flux a lot of confidence on the split side, I think, now that they've killed the Ranger.
Well, Pleb actually had an advantage getting the boss on their Ellie and then having a significant pressure advantage main team before that happened. Now it looks like they're going to be in an awkward position as Flux already has a flag on the Necro coming to the stand while Pleb, their backup flag is still in the base. So it's going to be interesting to see how they run this next flag.
Rudy's almost engaging the Ranger there. Nice dodging of the Burning Arrow and pin down. The nice plays by Rudy to be safe there. Looks like Pleb might be thinking about running on Monk again. Nope. He's just going back in the game. Pleb needs to go back for a flag very soon there.
Well, it's going to be dangerous because the Ellie on Pleb is pushed very far up and he's actually taking damage from the Footman as well. So it could be very dangerous if they only have two Monks main and this Ellie gets trained out.
Yeah, he's got a Hemorrhoid in him right now. He might just actually go actually run flag. We need to run on something, whatever they do.
It looks like their number 8 is going back right now to run this flag. But
that's gonna make the Ellie pretty vulnerable. As you can see, he's already getting trained out.
Well, it looks like they're gonna have to run with the Ellie because Flux has two guys in the front and this one Ranger will not be able to defend it. Like, they still haven't started running flags. So, I mean, Pleb is going to be really far behind. If they don't start running soon, Flux could boost off this.
So now we see Rudy, the lightning surge for Flux at the main team. The Flux is under a lot of pressure, but if Rudy pushes up, he might be able to kill the boss on Pleb's side. So Pleb is now running on Ranger there. So that's a nice move from
him. Well, Flux seemed to have a little bit of miscommunication where Rudy went all the way to his door to run the flag, and then he found out the Necro was already running. Yeah, and then Pleb takes advantage by scoring a kill on the Warrior. So despite a couple of good plays on the skirmish side from Flux, it looks like Pleb has taken control back of this game. They just have to get this flag through, which I think they will, before Flux is able to boost. Yeah, it looks like they're going to try to double run this flag with the Monk and the Ranger to get back ahead.
That's a great move by Pleb. But a feeling is if they have enough pressure that they don't have to worry about dying if they run a Monk flagger. Rudy is running up the top though. Looks like he's trying to maybe be sneaky and take out an archer.
Yeah, he might be able to get it because the stranger is probably gonna be running a flag out, and I don't think Pleb noticed him, but there's another kill, great kill.
Ooh,
by Pleb.
The flag.
Yeah, that's gonna be huge for them actually. Can they get this flag through? 3 seconds, wow. Wow, Flux actually was able to body block this flag and get the boost. That's pretty impressive. Honestly,
this is
I thought Pleb was gonna get that flag in for sure. So by getting that flag through, it looks like, I mean, Flux still has to run another flag because they got their flag returned. But by getting that boost, it seems like they're back practically even on morale. You could even say they're ahead.
Rudy wasn't able to get that archer down because the ranger came back. He might be able to get it down now though. The Ellie of Pleb is coming back to double run the flag, and the Ranger will go back and defend again.
And we see that the Dervish is actually running the flag now for Flux. So instead of having the Necro, which is more conventional, they decided to send the Dervish. Maybe they plan on double running as they're behind on flags right now.
And this does allow Pleb to run on their flag again now. He's going back. No, he's come back to main team actually. Maybe
this is actually really risky for Pleb though. Like, they're holding this flag on their boss when they already have the flag cap, so he's probably not going to be able to hand it off. He just ate an enrage for 124.
Pleb doesn't seem to be under so much pressure though, so they might be fine. And the strip has already been used, so it's gonna be difficult to
Yeah, it's not as bad because Flux is running the flag on their Dervish, so they're not able to train out the Ellie as effectively without their Dervish.
So, okay, we see the Ranger for a Pleb now splitting Flux's base. Following Rudy all the way back, and Rudy will take this chance to run the flag out.
This is actually a pretty smart play from Flux, because I don't think the back archer is that important. And if they can get ahead on flags off this, it might be worth it, as long as this ranger doesn't get any more NPCs.
Yeah, Flux under quite a bit of pressure at main team. They haven't run a flag though, so once Flux catches this flag, Pleb will have to run a flag.
Well, they haven't sent anything back for the stranger, so theoretically the stranger could get the whole pit. It's gonna kill this archer very soon and then start working on the knights.
But this trade-off is that Pleb have to run flag now, so if they start running flag while Flux is all 8 guys main, it'll be an 8v6 for Flux. And they'll have an opportunity to score some kills. The Ellie should be full on energy right now, considering he's been running around the map. But no, Flux actually takes a death in the 8v7. That's really rough.
Yeah, it looks like Pleb is just dominating right now in the flag stand game. I think Flux is probably gonna think about using its build comp, which is more suitable for skirmishes, to split around the map.
Yeah, Flux definitely have to change things up, I think. Because they really need to take out this boss Ellie somehow, and what they've been doing doesn't seem to be that effective at doing
that. Losing on both sides. I mean, they did well to get that boost, but they lost a knight in their base, they've been taking deaths at stand. So it looks like Pleb has the upper hand right now.
So I see the ranger now of Flux pushing the front door. Looks like they're trying to sort of give up on winning by this APA and maybe trying to skirmish a little bit more.
Oh, the boss ally for Pleb is actually in a very rough position right now. Flux has all their damage there, and Pleb is running on their number 8 right now, so let's see if Flux can maybe get a kill on this boss ally.
Getting a little bit close there. If that crushing blow hit, it would have been very low health.
It looks like Pleb is actually doing a good job of keeping the boss up.
Flux just doesn't seem to have all that much pressure on Pleb though, so...
Well, they're back on this boss, and let's see if they can... he got pretty low there, but yeah, it doesn't seem like they have the degen spread that they need. Flux did manage to sneak this Ellie into Pleb's base, but Pleb is defending now with the Ranger, so they should not lose any NPCs off this.
Nice pin down dodge by Rudy. The Ranger, I'm sure, will be back in time. This is actually little bit of a risky position for Flux's split ally to be in, because it is actually collapsible considering how far Pleb is pushed up right now.
Well, he was able to dodge that pin down, so I'm pretty sure he's gonna be fine. But yeah, I mean, Flux is just taking deaths, another death at main team. So, I mean,
just going for it would be...
It looks like Flux is just trying to split its Ranger and its Ellie to force Pleb to run on damage, specifically this boss Ellie.
Yeah,
which will definitely
like,
relieve some pressure.
It feels like Flux is trying to hold on to this game. Because the longer this goes, the more it gets into Pleb's favor. They're defending the Ranger with the boss Ellie, which is going to be extremely effective for Pleb. This Ranger is definitely not going to be able to 1v1.
Oh, Rudy just ate a pin down from this Ranger. I don't like. He might be able to kill this Ellie.
Oh,
nice dodge on the pin down. That was very close. If he hit that, that probably would have been a dead Ellie in the back door.
Oh,
and a return kill from Flux. I think that was a slight positioning mistake. Look at where he is and look at where his team is.
This might allow Flux to take the footman. Oh, actually, it looks like the Ellie for Pleb is running the flag out with boss still, and he's kind of in a risky position. He gets Lightning Surge interrupted there. If the Dervish went on him right now, they would have maybe been able to... well, had a chance of killing him, but actually, Rudy does go down.
Well, Rudy takes a death from... how did he die? I wasn't even paying attention. I'm assuming from the Ranger.
Must have been the Ranger and the Mesmer.
The Ranger killed him. Oh, the Ellie for Pleb, though, he actually got really low from this Hammer Warrior.
It looks like
the monks are in range.
It might be a snare from Fletch's number 8.
That would make sense. Okay, so it looks like Flux has changed it up. Their Ellie just base res, so he's bringing the next flag. But Flux has to be careful. Their warrior just almost died there. Every single time they get stuck in these AVA situations, it looks like Pleb has the upper hand. They've been scoring a lot more kills.
So Pleb will have to run another flag after Flux caps. The NPC advantage does slightly go to Pleb at the moment, having a knight down in the pit of Flux. So it looks like Pleb still has the advantage in this game.
Yeah, it's interesting because Pleb's been running a lot of flags on this Ranger this game, which is quite unusual, but I guess with their build composition, it's their best option.
Flux pushing up very aggressively right now on the alley. Gaining a lot of positioning from it as well. But they haven't started running it. Okay, they're starting to run another flag now, the Necro. So this will be actually a really nice positioning for them to be in if Pleb decides to run on the Ellie, but looks like they are running on the Ranger, so that will be just fine for them. Rudy actually is in a position where he might be able to take out the boss right here.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what happens. Unfortunately, it looks like Flux lost most of their pressure, but...
Oh, he takes out the boss!
Nice spike!
Yeah, there we go.
That was a great spike from,
Rudy. Rudy. That was a solo.
Yeah, that was a great, great play. And they're gonna be way ahead on flags as well. Like, they already have a backup coming, and Pleb is spending a lot of energy getting this flag in.
So that actually might allow Rudy to take on the Ranger 1v1 now as well, that he is boss with Drip on. So that'll be interesting to see. I'm not sure how that matchup goes exactly, but it'll be much more favorable than before.
It's really smart because Rudy can easily 1v1 the Ellie from Pleb. So Biggie right now, it's going to be very hard for him to defend this Ellie. And yeah, he's just running away. That's going to give up knights for sure.
So this is looking a lot better for Flux than it was a couple minutes ago. That boss catapulted him ahead.
He might get this other knight. I mean, I don't know what a Mystic region. I'm assuming he has Mystic. Ellie is going to be able to do against the Spirit Bond Ellie.
So yeah, this is actually an interesting matchup. I haven't really tested this one out. It's Spirit Bond with boss against Mystic region. And I think that the Mystic region might be able to win it, but I really don't know. Because the damage you do goes so high that it goes so significantly above the Spirit Bond range. Yeah, it might make you able to kill the Ellie for Spirit Bond. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I mean, it would be an interesting matchup to see for sure, but it looks like Rudy's just playing it safe. And, maybe he's going for this 1v1. Maybe we'll be able to see it. Nope, it looks like he's just, it's just a seesaw battle.
We might be baiting him out into the open so they can't use NPCs. Looks like that actually is what he's doing.
Yeah, well, it looks like, yeah.
So Rudy's got 66 from Spirit Bonds, which means that he's running 9 plus.
I think it looks like Rudy has the upper hand still in this matchup. He's just able to get his scales off faster.
This looks pretty significant. Like, he's winning this quite easily.
Yeah, he's winning quite easily. He might get the solo kill here.
Oh, he's
actually, in fact,
back a
he should
bit.
Get the solo kill. He should get the solo kill here.
Come on, Rudy.
Oh.
Come on, Rudy. Oh, I think he might just miss it.
Yeah, I think he could have got it. I think he messed up his skill order a little bit, but either way, that was a great play for him.
Yeah, that's fantastic for him to know that he can do that now. So he'll be much more confident.
Yeah, I think this is a really risky option for Pleb to be trying to defend this Ellie with their Ellie. I think Biggie needs to probably use his own NPCs, or he's gonna lose this 1v1 out in the open. Yeah, exactly, he has to run away. I mean,
so Flux is running on the Necro, getting pushed by Dervish right now at the front door, and the Ranger. The number 8 is the Flux is following there. So if anything, this will actually be super risky. It actually might be a dead Dervish if Necro caught
him. Dervish, yeah, this... I mean, he's gonna degen out there. Here comes the Ranger. This Dervish will probably die. I mean, Scott's trying to save him. Ooh, it looks like he's gonna get there just
damn.
In time.
Nice. A little bit of a misplay by the Necro there.
Back in the base, Rudy was able to snipe an archer. At this rate, he's gonna be able to slowly snipe the entire base of Plebs. I mean, Biggie's just not able to fight him 1v1.
Looks like Pleb might be collapsing through the back door though with the Ranger, so this is a great move by them, recognizing that they can't keep up this 1v1, so it looks like they might be trying to collapse right now, which is fantastic for them.
Yeah, this is a good play. Rudy's best option right now, since he's got the archer, he can run straight through though. It looks like that's what he's going for. It's a great play from Rudy, recognizing the Ranger collapsing and getting out through the portal.
So it's still going to be quite a risky skirmish though. It'll be a 2v2. Actually, the Dervish for Pleb is coming up, so it's gonna favor Pleb. Ooh, actually,
Rudy's
going down.
Looks like Rudy's gonna go down here. Yeah, he's gonna go down here.
It gives the boss to the BA Ranger, so I think it looked like Rudy might have been caught without Spirit Bond there for a moment.
That was
to the BA Ranger.
That was some huge miscommunication from Flux. They had 3 damage at the portal, and Flux's monk seemed to be late responding.
So I think that having boss on this Ranger will be absolutely fantastic for Pleb. This BA Ranger bar with pin down really doesn't have all that much energy to spam your skills like BA, Savage Shot, and pin down with apply poison at the same time. So having boss will really allow him to take advantage like of the extra energy. So he might really enjoy that.
Well, let's see what's happening with flags right now. I mean, Pleb is running this flag on the Warrior. It seems like they're having a very difficult time. He's just getting perma snared by this Dervish. Seems like a great play from Flux.
If Flux's Necro actually comes down, they could have been able to kill him already, but actually it looks like the Necro is being trained out a little bit by some interrupts from the Mesmer Pleb.
Yeah, I mean, this Warrior is just having a really difficult time getting this fight game. He just gets it in, but Pleb is in a really bad spot right now. They're full flag behind, and it doesn't seem entirely obvious what they're going to run the flag with. I'm assuming the Ellie, but we'll see. It looks like they're sending the Boss Ranger back, actually, to run the
flag. That's interesting. I would have thought they might want to keep the Boss Ranger at main team, considering how powerful it could be. But I guess that maybe they feel like
Dervish
it's a little
risky. Down here. He barely gets away. It's a great save from the monks.
So Rudy's splitting up again?
This is a good play from Rudy. Like, they've been having a lot of success being able to split off this L-Surge with Spirit Bond.
We could see another
he's
1v1
already gotten
here.
An Archer. Yeah, he's already gotten an Archer and a Knight. I mean,
we could see another 1v1 here, then. I'm actually really not sure who wins between the Boss Ranger and the Ellie with Spirit Bond. So that will be very interesting to see if we can come out on top if Rudy decides to engage.
Yeah, these are some very interesting 1v1 matchups this game with the boss. Something we actually rarely see in a lot of these games. But it looks like Pleb is pushing this flag with their number 8 monk. It looks like Flux doesn't have too much pressure on them, so they should be able to get this flag through. But Flux is doing a good job of snaring him.
So Flux is in just fantastic position right now. Full flag ahead, NPC advantage, and a little bit of morale advantage. What's going for Pleb right now? They've got the boss on their side. And that's pretty much it. And, well, I guess that they would have a kind of stronger AVA considering that they were winning the AVA 2-4. So,
well,
it's still pretty even.
I think, like, Pleb, the best chance here is try to force as much AVA as they possibly can. They were having a lot of success doing that. So the more AVA situations they can get to, it probably helps their chances of pulling out this game.
See Rudy very aggressively pushing the front door. There's nothing really they can do with him though, if the Ranger is running flag, which is very interesting. Because the Elso Jelly will not be able to hurt him much through Spirit Bond in the front line. Will cause Flux's backline to push up. So yeah, this is a very nice push.
I think it's a very interesting decision that Pleb is continuously running this flag with his boss, Ranger.
Like
it looks like
it actually. But, oh, he's getting so low. That's pretty close.
Yeah, he's taking a lot of damage with this boss. Let's see what Rudy decides to do here. I mean, he has a free pass to the base. I mean, it's very easy to hit the archer from
the
bottom, actually. Yeah, you could definitely get this archer down.
This is really smart
which would
play
be
by
huge.
Rudy.
He's actually going for the outside archer instead of the inside archer, which is an interesting decision, but he's definitely going to get it down. So that's a good play by him.
Flux could push up a monk now as well, and it looks like they are. So Flux is playing very, very smart. Making it very difficult for Pleb to come back. The Pleb do cut the flag, but Flex caps right over, so Pleb is going to have to run another flag.
Yeah, I mean, Pleb is in a... It's very difficult for Pleb to actually... it's hard for them to decide who to run the flags on. It looks like their best option is the Ellie, but they're going to take a lot of pressure when he gets trained out.
Flux still playing very smart on the Ranger that was trying to follow Rudy there. It looked like Rudy might have actually been trying to pull the Ranger out of position a little bit and maybe take him out with the boss. So it's...
Well, as long as Flux can maintain flag advantage, I think they're gonna... I mean, it's already almost 24 minutes, so as long as they can maintain this flag advantage, it's gonna be very difficult for Pleb to kill them as they can't consistently keep all their damage there and casting.
This might actually be a chance for, Pleb to push up right now and take out the flag now that the Ellie's up the top, but the Ranger actually pushes the front door. The Dervish pushes as well, so it's going to actually allow Flux to send back some monks. Have they just pushed with the Ellie? It would have been difficult for Flux to push with pull back with their monks.
Well, Pleb,
but
Pleb
this is actually successful.
Here, actually.
Ooh, that actually
yeah,
worked out for them.
It was
fantastic.
It was only one monk against. They have 4 damage here. Look at this. They have 4 damage. And
I thought that they
at
had
that
two
point.
Monks. Oh, well, that was a great move though by Pleb then, I guess.
Yeah, it looks like they're just beelining for the base. I don't know if this is. Well, okay, they're turning around now.
Scar is going
down.
Yeah,
it seems like.
Get saved.
It seems like they might be able to kill these two monks or maybe a collapse. Yeah, it looks like they're doing a collapse, which might be smart because Flux is trying to push Pleb's base with one monk. So if Pleb is able to collapse here, they could definitely get some kills.
Wow, these monks look like they might be going down. Okay, one of them goes down. This is really risky now for Pleb.
Yeah, their number 8 is going to go down in no time. That's 3
if we get a shadow
right
on the dervish right now,
month.
The Mesmer could shadow the dervish from the side. Nope. The dervish was
this number 8 monk, Sky, is gonna go down. He just ate an enraged. He's gonna die. Like, there's.
And the dervish
no
does
other
go
monk.
Down.
Yeah, there we go.
It doesn't look like Lego has a res. Whereas Flux's Ranger does have a res. So this is really not what Pleb wants.
Yeah, this is really back and forth, and Flux is able to get a flag in, so Pleb doesn't even boost off this. So that was actually a really messy exchange, but Flux definitely came out on top.
Yeah, and we see the monks of Flux down the bottom here, outside of the pit, actually able to heal the place inside the pit. But Flux are forced to pull out, which is great for Pleb. They came very close to losing there, but were able to regain control of their base.
Well, Flux has a huge advantage right now. They have almost the entire pit down and great positioning for 28, which is coming up here. Pleb would really need a huge play in order to win at 28, it looks like. Flux is already in position to defend. It looks like they're defending with the standard Necro. Yeah, Ranger Necro. The Necro's already sitting in their base, which is great for them.
Boss Ranger Pleb is already pushing quite aggressively, and here comes, I think, four players. So they might actually not be able to get lore damage with just this, with just 4 players. Pleb, that is, which is interesting.
Yeah, Pleb definitely needs to push more into the base.
It looks like Flux also have 4 characters though, but they do have a lot of NPCs down.
There's
ooh,
no, yeah.
Flux
ooh,
goes down.
Wow, that was.
Oh my.
That was actually a huge kill if they can keep these reses down. There's only going to be one monk against these 3 damage.
But they have got a lot of the pit though, so they still might die if they try and push this monk straight away. And they haven't got any enchant removal, so the prop monks, props will last. Oh, the guardian gets
D-shot! They have to get these NPCs down. They really have to
warrior
get these
goes
NPCs down.
Down. Oh, pushing it just slightly too early. The monk wasn't really in range long enough to heal. And the monk goes down as well.
They had to take it slow. They had to take out the NPCs first and then push in. Because, Flux still had 2 damage healers. But wow, the monk and the flag. Okay, the flagger just got rezzed. This is very interesting, actually, still.
This is just so back and forth.
Yeah, it looks like Flux is dying in Pleb's base. They're not really getting much lore damage, but Pleb just completely wiped in Flux. I don't think either team got very much lore damage, but I think Flux has gotten slightly more because Pleb just had less NPCs.
Yeah, if Flux is able to get any lore damage right now, it would help them significantly. Because, yeah, I'm not sure if Pleb got any lore damage. I think they were just going for the kill and got a little bit of regressive.
Well, I think Pleb made a slight mistake where they only sent 4 players to Flux's base. If they had sent 5, I think they could have definitely wiped both their monks.
Well, I think that, yeah, sending 4 does seem like a little bit few places in, but it did work out really, really well for them when they scored those kills, except they were just pushed a little bit too aggressively, I think, and they were taken out by the damage characters and the NPCs. So yeah, great job.
Yeah, that's true.
Great job to Flux. That was actually a really interesting game, very back and forth.
Yeah, that was actually a very exciting game, lots of action.
Yeah, thanks for watching, and see you next time.